Hello everyone, this is Dr. Ashish Vanwai and welcome to the video lecture on how to solve the problems of morphological image processing. This is video 4 in this series, and in this video we will see the problems of region filling algorithm. The question over here is, perform the region filling operation to fill the image A using structuring element B. And they have given image A and structuring element B. Now if you observe that image, they have given in terms of white boxes and gray boxes. Now here, the gray boxes actually indicate the value 1 or the white region. And the white boxes actually indicate the value 0. So please remember this point if you are writing this in terms of 1s and 0s. Similarly, if you look at the structuring element, then you can see it's a 3x3 structuring element, and they have marked the center of a structuring element with a small circle. So it is the second row, second column of the structuring element. And the structuring element has the value 1 at the center, and the 4 neighbors are 1, whereas the diagonal neighbors are 0. Okay. So whenever you see the problems of morphological image processing, one has to be slightly careful while writing them as ones and zeros. Okay, you normally look at the structuring element and then one can check which values are actually ones and which values are actually zeros. The region filling algorithm is actually an iterative algorithm. For region filling, xk is given as xk minus 1 dilated with b, and the result is then taken with the intersection of A complement, where k takes the value 1, 2, 3, etc. And x0 is a point inside the boundary to be filled. So that becomes the starting point of the algorithm. And the algorithm terminates if xk is same as xk minus 1. And then the final filled image, that is A filled, is given as A union xk. There will be three main steps for this algorithm. Step 1 is to select the starting point of filling, that is to select x0. The step 2 is an iterative step where xk is equal to xk minus 1 dilated with b, and then whatever the result, we take the intersection with A complement till xk is same as xk minus 1. So we will perform this step iteratively, and then finally the filled image will be calculated as A union xk. So let's select the starting point x0 for region filling algorithm. So you can see the image A over here. Just for understanding, the region of A to be filled is marked with the orange color over here. That means when we select the x0, that x0 has to be one of the pixels from these orange patches. So you can select any one. The number of iterations actually will depend on how you select this starting point. So for the timing, let's select the first corner point, which is shown in the second image over here. So that will become our starting point x0. Now we will perform the step 2 iteratively. So we will start with x0, we will dilate that x0 with b, and we will take the intersection with A complement, and that will give us x1. For dilation, we need to consider the b cap when we find the overlap. So over here, since the given structuring element is symmetric, the b cap will be same as b. We will find the A complement and we will keep it ready. So you can see the corresponding image A and its complement. So first image is original image A and the second is the corresponding complemented image. So let's start with the first iteration. So we will dilate x0 with B, and whatever the result, we are going to find the intersection with A complement. So you can see x0 in the first image. You can see the B or the B cap in the second image, both are same over here. and the corresponding result of dilation of x0 with b is shown in the third image. Now just for a quick guess, the b is a kind of a plus structure where the center element is 1 and the four neighbors are also 1 and the diagonal neighbors are 0. That means when we dilate, the object will go in the four directions, okay, that is the four neighbors. It will not grow in the diagonal neighbors. That is how we are calculating the dilation result quickly over here. We will take the intersection of the result of dilation and A complement. So you can see the result of dilation in the first figure, the A complement in the second figure, and the corresponding intersection is in the third figure. So that third figure is nothing but now x1, that is the result of the first iteration. If you observe carefully, what you will find that the A complement actually has prevented the dilation result to go outside the region to be filled. We will check x1 with x0. If both are same, our algorithm will terminate. Here they are not same, so we will start with iteration 2. So in this case, we are going to dilate x1 with b, and then whatever the result, we are going to take intersection with a complement. So x1, the corresponding b is shown, and now what we are going to do is we are going to dilate it with b. So you can see that corresponding result in the third image, where we have actually expanded the components of x1 in the four neighbors direction. We will take the intersection of x1 dilated with b and a complement. So you can see the x1 in the first figure over here, the a complement is shown in the second figure, and the corresponding result of the intersection is shown in the third figure, and that is nothing but our x2. And now if you observe over here, our x2 is same as x1 over here, hence our algorithm will terminate. Now the final step is to find the filled image, which is A union with xk, and in this case the xk is x2, that means we are going to find the union of A and x2. So here you can see the first image as A, the corresponding x2 is shown in the second figure, and their interunion, that is the filled image, is shown in the third figure. Let's take another example of region filling. So here the question is again to perform the region filling operation to fill the image A using the structuring element B. And again, if you observe, there is a 8x8 image given over here, which is something like a pattern of I, and the structuring element is same as the previous problem. So as you have seen in the earlier problem, the formulation of region filling has three steps. The step one is to select the starting point of region to be filled, that is to select the x0 point. The second step is an iterative step where we keep on filling the region, and the algorithm terminates if we don't have any change in the filled region. And the third step is to find the final filled image, which is given as the union of A and xk. So let's start with the step one, that is to select x0. You can see the image over here, and we can identify the region that we have to fill in the object of A. Again, for simplicity, the region to be filled is marked with the orange patch over here. That means we will have to select one of the pixels from this orange patch as x0. And this selection will now become very critical. So if you select somewhere in the center of the orange patch, you will require less number of iterations for filling the algorithm. If you select any of the corner points as the starting point, then the algorithm will take more number of iterations. So what I'm doing over here, I have selected one point that is shown in the second figure over here as a starting point. So that becomes my x0. Of course, the student can try with some other point as a starting point, and they can see how the algorithm works over there. Step 2 is to iteratively perform the operation of dilation and intersection. That means whatever xk minus 1 will dilate with b, and whatever the result will take the intersection with a complement, and that will become our new xk. And we'll continue this process till xk is equal to xk minus 1. And in this case, the structuring element is a symmetric structuring element, hence we have b same as b cap. That means the reflected version of b is same as the original structuring element. For this process we will require the a complement, so we have found it over here. So first figure is the original image A, and the second figure shows the corresponding a complement. Let's start with the iteration 1. So for iteration 1, we are going to dilate x0 with b, and whatever the result, we are going to take the intersection with a complement, and that is going to give us x1. So you can see the x0 in the first figure over here. You can see the b, which is same as the b complement, in the second figure, and the result of dilation is shown in the third figure over here. So again, as I said in the earlier problem, here the structuring element is kind of a plus shape. Hence, when we dilate, it is going to expand the object in the four neighbors. It is not going to expand along the diagonal neighbors. Okay. So this is the first result of the dilation of x0 with b. We are then going to find its intersection with a complement. So you can see the result of x0 dilation with b in the first figure. You can see the a complement in the second figure, and then the corresponding intersection is shown in the third figure, and the third figure becomes our x1. So you can again see that the a complement intersection with a complement has prevented the dilation to go out of the region to be filled. Now we will compare x1 with x0. If both are same, we will terminate the algorithm. If not, we are going to go for the next iteration. Here x1 is not same as x0, so we will go for iteration 2. In the iteration 2, we are going to dilate x1 with b. The corresponding result, we are going to take the intersection with a complement, and that will give us x2. So you can see the x1 in the first figure, b, which is same as b cap, in the second figure, and you can see the result of x1 dilation with b in the third figure. As I said earlier, again we have expanded x1 in the four neighbors direction. We now find the result of intersection of x1 dilated with b and a complement. So x1 erode b, sorry, x1 dilated with b is shown in the first figure, a complement is shown in the second figure, and the corresponding result of the intersection is shown in the third figure. So this third figure becomes our x2. Again we will compare x2 with x1. If both are same, the algorithm will terminate, otherwise we will go for the next iteration. Here x2 is not same as x1, hence we will have the next iteration. For third iteration, we are going to dilate x2 with b, and then the corresponding result, we are going to take intersection with a complement, which will give us x3. So you can see x2 in the first figure over here, the b which is same as b cap in the second figure, and the result of dilation is shown in the third figure. We now find the intersection of the result with a complement. So result of x2 dilation with b is shown in the first figure, a complement is shown in the second figure, and the result of intersection is shown in the third figure, and that becomes our x3. Again we will compare x3 with x2. Here it is not same, hence we will have the fourth iteration. For the fourth iteration, it will be x3 dilation with b, and then whatever result, intersection with a complement. So x3 b is shown in first and second figure respectively, and the corresponding result of dilation is shown in the third figure. Now the result of dilation and a convolution will take the intersection. So you can see x3 dilated with b in the first figure, a complement in the second figure, and the corresponding result of intersection is shown in the fourth figure. That will become our x4. Again, we will compare x4 with x3. They are not same, so we will have iteration number 5. For iteration 5, it will be x4 dilated with b. Whatever the result, we are going to take intersection with a complement, which will give us xy. So you can see x4 in the first figure, the corresponding b, which is same as b cap in the second figure, and the result of dilation in the third figure. We now find the intersection with a complement. So you can see the result of x4 dilated with b in the first figure, a complement in the second figure, and result of intersection in the third figure. So this result of intersection is our xy now. And if we compare xy b with x4, we find that both are same. Hence, we will terminate the iterations. And now we will perform the last step, that is to find the final field image. So my A field, which is given as A union with XK, which will be same as in this particular case, our algorithm terminated after fifth iteration. So it will be A union with X5. So you can see the A in the first figure over here. The corresponding XY is shown in the second figure. And the field image, that is the union of the first and the second image, is shown in the third image. So finally, we get the result over here of the A field. Now in this particular case, we started with the x0, which was somewhere around the center. I advise student to take some other point and perform this region filling algorithm, and to identify how the iterations change and how many iterations in addition you may require if you change a point that is not at the center of the region to be filled. So this brings us to the end of this particular video, as well as the video series on how to solve the problems of morphological image processing. If you have any doubts, you can always write back to me on my email ID, that is ivpashish@gmail.com. The links of all these videos you can find on my webpage at ashishvanmali.wordpress.com. Thank you.